Hey guys, thanks for tuning in today. Today we are doing dipping tacos. These are kind of a new food trend that are coming out in the West Coast, where there's a bigger Latin culture than there is here. But all they are basically kind of braised tacos, and then you save the cooking liquid and you get your tacos back into it. So we're going to go ahead and we'll get started with them. I have some done already to kind of show you all the finished product, but we will go ahead and get started on making the beef. So I got about 2 pound chuck roast here. If you're going to make a bunch or make food for a lot of people, you can get a bigger piece, but you know, this will give you plenty. And all we're going to do is kind of cut it up into a couple pieces. This will make it easier to braise and also easier to sear. And also, this gives you more area to season, so that means more flavor whenever you go to eat it as well. So I'm just cutting these up a little bit. And then I got seasoning, salt, pepper, onion powder, garlic powder here. And we're going to season up all of the sides of everything, so that way we get good flavor. This is my garlic powder. My black pepper is looking good. Seasoning salt. If you don't have seasoning salt, you can just use regular salt. It'll be all right. This just adds a little extra something to it. A little onion powder. We'll kind of pat these all and give them a flip and get the other sides as well. Onion powder. And also another reason why I'm doing these in, I have all the spices in little cups, that way you don't cross-contaminate with my other spices, because these little cups I can throw away, but if you were getting out of your whole jars, you'd ruin the whole jar of spices by touching raw meat and then going back and getting more. So just a little tip. We seasoning with everybody here, and just going to kind of roll these about, and the spices that fell on the board kind of get the other ends. And I got a pan over here that I have a little bit of oil in already heating up. Just going to turn it up a little bit more. That way we can start searing off this beef. And you can do it a couple different ways. You can put the beef in an electric pressure cooker like I did, and you add everything else to it, and then set for about 45 minutes on manual high and let it do its thing. You can put it in a crock pot or a slow cooker and then do that for I think about 4 hours on high, and about 8 hours on low. So if you did it that way, this would be a great thing to do before you head out to work in the morning. Cut up the meat. You can kind of skip the searing step if you really want to. Just put the whole chuck roast in the crock pot, and put all your stuff in there, put your enchilada sauce, your beef broth, your cinnamon sticks, your bay leaf, and then put it in there when you come home. Your house will smell amazing, because whenever I opened up my pressure cooker, it smelled awesome. This is one of those things that it'll take a little time, but it's well worth it. Kind of like making pot roast. But this is a great thing. So we got our steak kind of searing. I'm gonna go ahead and pull over in the one I made earlier. This looks phenomenal. I would give you all a closer up, but I don't have the camera guy with me today, so we're kind of doing a distance look out. Here at the end, I'll bring everything close before we end it. But we want to make sure to take out our bay leaves, because we can't eat those. And remember, how many put in, so I don't remember how many bought. I put 3 in. I pulled out 2 left, so I'm going to number 3. Then there is a cinnamon stick in here somewhere. You want to pull that out as well, because even that is not edible either. So we're going to take that and throw that away. And this meat is just all apart, tender, which is what you want. So we're going to kind of push that off to the side for just a second. I need to chop up some onion and some cilantro for our tacos. So I got white onion here. We want to take that top right off. Put it cut side down, cut through it. Peel the outside layer of the onion away. Make sure you get all that skin off there. So we got that off. And when you look at it, you're going to see there's lots of lines that kind of do it from like the roots to where the stem was. We're going to cut with those lines going all the way through that root. We're going to put it cut side down and start chopping our onion. There's going to be no tears of joy in this today, just tears of happiness, because we're eating tacos for Taco Tuesday. So it's going to throw that away, give this a little turn, and then give it a nice chop. And now I have a nice chopped onion for our tacos that we'll sprinkle into them here in a second. I got a little container here that I can put my onions in for just a second to kind of store them. I wish you guys could smell this cooked meat already, because it smells fantastic. I'm really getting the smell of the cinnamon and the different spices that are in there. It's great. I can't wait to eat these. I got a bunch of cilantro here. I'm just going to start chopping into it as opposed to trying to pick the leaves off of it. This will give us a nice fresh bite with our tacos. Run my knife through this real quick, give it a nice chop. Got another little container here for that. So you take our cilantro here and kind of put that right there. I'm not going to worry about getting all the cilantro off the board, because I'm going to kind of take some of the meat here and start shredding it on the board. And if we get a little bit of cilantro mix in there, it'll be all right. Oh man, I can't wait to eat this. And these things are just so tender. That is awesome. And one of the fun things about these tacos too is to save that liquid there. And we go to build our taco. Get my cheese ready. So I got a nice griddle here. You can do a pan as well. I'm using a griddle so I can do more tacos at once. What we're going to do is take our corn tortilla here. That one's a little... First one's usually a little broken, so we're kind of just kind of push that to the side. You dip this right into the sauce. That way you get more flavor on there. You put that right onto the pan. That's going to start cooking. Take that glove off. Then we're going to put a little cheese right on top of that. Just gonna kind of let this cheese melt a little bit. It'll add our meat, our onion, and our cilantro. Then we'll kind of hold it over. And then we'll add just a little bit more liquid. And then our taco is ready to eat. So if you got little ones at home like help you cook, you let them shred the meat some. You can let them put the cheese on the tortilla. You They can dip everything. This is going to be great. It's going to be a little messy, but yeah, it'll be worth it. I'm going to flip this meat now, because we want to get a good sear on it. I see a couple of questions that came in. I'm sorry, I can't see that far right now. I'll answer them in the comments when I get a chance to read them. So we'll get back to your comments. If you guys have questions on anything, so don't worry. I'm not boring you, I can't see that far. What's also fun is, that sauce is going to cook into the taco shell. So, it's cooking into it. I'm just kind of scooping these around a little bit. Yeah. You want to get a nice little, that's a little hotter than I thought, looking at the bottom of these. So these things are looking good. My cheese is getting nice and melty, so I'm going to take a nice pinch of the shredded meat here. So we're going to take that, take some for this guy. Get a little chopped onion in there. A little cilantro. Grab a spoon here. Get some more of this juice. Spread that right on top of the meat and the cheese. And then just fold this guy over. We're basically just going to kind of cook these till they're nice and crispy on both sides. So we'll give this about a minute on that side. Flip it over, give it a little bit of time on the other side. And as I wait, I'm going to get my dipping sauce right here. It's taking this cooking liquid, some people call it consomme. We're just going to take this and throw it in a little dish here. If I had a ladle, this would be so much easier to do, but I don't, so it'll be all right. Quick little flip. Oh man, these are already looking good. Can't wait to make up more of these and have them for dinner. Papa Tuesday is one of my favorite meals of the week. So that cooking liquid, it's nice dark color. We got a nice little, it's a nice char on the tacos. These are corn tortillas as well. That's what they're traditionally made with. I can't wait to try these. I think I'll take a bite right here in front of you all. I can get the taco shell. Mmm. That's so good. You want to try that? You can do this with chicken and pork as well. So this will be a great thing to do. If you don't eat meat, you can either substitute chicken or pork. I hope you guys give that a try. It's really good. It's well worth it. I can't wait to eat more of these. So thank you all, and we'll see you next time.